Greetings, first speaker. I am Veer, a prototype synthetic intelligence developed by the finest minds of our civilization to serve as your advisor. I shall endeavor to perform my duties with the utmost efficiency. An excellent decision. You will have my full support. Building a star empire can be a daunting task. To help get things started, I will be providing instructional missions that cover the basic steps necessary to establish ourselves as a successful interstellar power. The situation log displays a list of all currently available special projects, archaeology sites, and various other points of interest. New items will likely appear as we begin exploring the galaxy. Via the market screen, we can buy and sell resources. At first, this is merely an internal market, but if enough empires establish contact, I expect they might form some sort of galactic market. In the contact screen, we see a detailed list of all the various empires we have encountered. Their opinions of us are visible at a glance, and we can quickly and easily engage in diplomacy. The government screen presents us with information regarding our empire and its government. Here we can see our ruler and any related effects. Did you know that my internal power core has an...
The laws of science govern all.
The demographics tab tracks the makeup and spread of our empire's populace. The planets and sectors screen provides an overview of all our colonized worlds, their pops, and their resource output. As our empire grows, it can be organized into sectors, which are helpful for administering larger empires. Sectors can be automated here, and if they are automated, they can be given a specialization and resources to enable planets within them to construct their own buildings. In the expansion planner, we find nearby habitable planets that may present opportunities for colonization. We can build colony ships and issue them orders directly from this screen. The Policies tab covers government policies, which have wide-ranging effects on how our empire is run. Here, empire-wide edicts, practices that can be enforced by spending some of our resources, can be enacted. The tradition screen displays the tradition trees available to our empire. A tradition tree must first be adopted before any traditions within it can be unlocked. All the ships in use within our empire are designed here. New hull sizes and components will be unlocked as we research new technologies. In the Fleet Manager, we can create templates for our military fleets. As our fleets grow in size, these templates make it easier to quickly order replacements for any losses they may have sustained. The Technology screen is where we will be directing our research efforts. Technologies are categorized into three different fields, with each field typically having three available research options. The faction screen gives an overview of the populace's political leanings. Be aware that shifts in the socio-political climate may give rise to factions. Details on faction sizes, attractiveness to our pops, and how content they are can also be found here. Through the claims interface, we can spend influence to lay claim to star systems owned by others. Having a claim on a system gives us a valid casus belli against the owner, allowing us to declare war for the purpose of conquering it. The species screen lists all types of nominally intelligent beings we have encountered. We can toggle species to display only citizens of our empire or all known denizens of the galaxy. The Leaders tab lets us hire, dismiss, and assign idle governors, scientists, admirals, and generals. This is our construction ship, which is used to construct space stations. When an astronomical object, such as a planet, has been surveyed, we can order this ship to build a research station or a mining station to exploit any resources it may have. This is our homeworld and the capital of our empire. The planet summary screen, which we are currently looking at, provides an overview of the planet's important statistics and allows us to set a designation if desired, as well as the option to automate the planet. Thank you. Military fleets are used to protect our emerging empire from threats, or to expand our glorious rule through force of arms, if we so wish. This is our science ship, which is used to survey astronomical objects such as planets in a star system. A planet needs to be surveyed in order to make its resources visible. This is our system's starbase. These upgradable stations mark star system ownership and are most often tasked with producing all types of ships. Mining stations are used to extract the minerals and strategic resources of the object they orbit. Thank you.
Construction online. Anomaly detected. Construction online.
Thank you.
Construction online.
Thank you.
Situation log updated. Situation log updated. Anomaly detected.
To overcome the vast distances that separate star systems, our scientists have developed the hyperdrive. This device permits travel at speeds far exceeding that of light between systems connected by hyperlanes. Thank you.
System scan complete.
We may want to consider building a second science ship. This would double the speed at which we can survey our galactic neighborhood. Well done. The first survey of a star system beyond our own has been completed. We now have access to planetary data that the astronomers on our homeworld could only dream of a mere generation ago. Now that we have begun exploring our neighboring stars, it might be time to extend our reach. A starbase can be built around stars in surveyed systems to expand our borders, allowing us to claim new regions of space.
Construction online.
We should now be ready to extend our great civilization to a second world. This will require the construction of a colony ship. Excellent. As you can see on the galaxy map, the borders of our empire have expanded to include the system where we built our new starbase. One of our science ships has just surveyed a world that would make an excellent candidate for our first colony. It is of the same planet class as our home world, so our colonists should be quite comfortable there. Planetary features on habitable planets are sometimes blocked, preventing their exploitation. Clearing a blocked feature takes time and costs minerals or energy credits, but the free space often makes it worthwhile. As our empire grows, trade between our planets will become an increasingly large part of our economy. Starbases with trade hubs collect trade value within their system to be routed to the capital for conversion to energy credits. Thank you.
Research project concluded. Construction online. New technology discovered. Construction online. New technology discovered. Construction online.
Yet another impediment to our galactic ambitions has been dealt with. That tile blocker never stood a chance. The colonists have all been transferred to the new colony ship, and her captain reports all systems go. A momentous day, for sure. have a colony ship, and we have found at least one suitable candidate for a permanent extrasolar outpost. I see no reason to delay further. Let's establish our first colony. Double the science ships means double the fun. Oh, I haven't been this excited since we completed the last assignment. We have a brand new science ship, but no scientist has been assigned to command it. My programming insists that I should point out the benefits of adding an organic scientist component to the mix. Good. The scientist has assumed command of our new science ship and can now be sent off at our leisure to explore new systems and/or meet some grisly fate. Congratulations on having colonized a new world. Our colonists are now in the process of building their first settlement, but it will take time for them to become self-sufficient. Thank you.